Yeah, g'day viewers. Top of another mountain this time. We're overlooking the beautiful Lake Wanaka, Wanaka Lake, down there. A few snow-capped mountains. You little ripper. Goes all the way down there. Wanaka's down there somewhere. We drove there half an hour up here, and then it's about a 4-hour hike to the top of this one. And then the bonus of this hike is, oh, there's my climbing partner, Ruby. Say hello, Ruby.
Not another bloody video.
Hey, what? Yeah, you're famous. Home base check crew love you.
Okay.
Frankie and Gracie, you guys like Ruby, don't you? Henry, Vivi, Rosie, do you like Ruby? You can message me and let me know. Thumbs up or thumbs down on Ruby. And then, what's the name of that lake? The other one?
Hawea.
I
don't know if that's how you say it.
Two lakes. We get to view two lakes for the price of one hike. Two for one. That's not a bad deal. Not a bad deal. Okay. So that's it. G'day, viewers. How are you? Coming here. I just want to show you a quick survival trick here in the mountains of wild New Zealand. If you're ever stuck over here overnight, what you need to find is this good mountain grass. This stuff here. So these top bits here. If you're ever stuck, this is perfect to eat any time, day or night. Yeah, that's good eating. That's real good eating. So if you ever get stuck and you're hungry up in the mountains, this is perfect. That'll help you overnight. And you can also make a bed of it and actually just sleep in it like this. Just wrap yourself up and that's good for a night. You're fine here. See you later, viewers.
Videos everywhere we go. So annoying. Ugh.
G'day viewers. Just thought I'd share a couple of quick tips about rock climbing in the mountains. You know, you always want to have 3 points of contact. Otherwise you'll fall off the face of a cliff. So that means either 2 feet and a hand, or 2 hands and a feet, a foot. Now, you can see when I go for my next move up here, I've got 3 good anchor points, and then you swing the extra arm, like that, and then you can bring your next leg around, and then you hold on. Now, the other option is to just walk up as well. That's also possible. And it's sometimes a bit quicker. But 3 anchor points is always a good thing to remember anyway. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. Okay, guys. Come here. I want to show you something. If you're ever stuck for bush tucker up in the mountains in New Zealand, get yourself 2 sticks like this. And if you listen carefully to the echo, you should be able to find some food pretty quick. So. The echo reverberating where the bush tucker is going to be. Oh, see that? Easy. It's as easy as that to find a bit of bush tucker up here. I'm going to get stuck into this. Thanks for watching. Guys, just a quick tip. If you're ever stuck up in the mountains, it's getting kind of low sunlight at night time, and you want to call out for help, the old Aussie bush trick is a cooey. So what you do is, you go, you hear that? Coo-wee! And that will echo down to help. That noise will bounce all the way down, and then they'll send up a chopper real quick for us. So we should see a chopper coming up anytime real quick now, and they should rescue us pretty quick. So we'll wait here for the chopper. Catch you later. Yeah, just a quick update on the helicopter. It looks like didn't turn up. They mustn't have heard my bush trick. So we're going to have to walk down before it gets dark. Sorry, Ruby, is that okay with you?
No comment.
I don't think she likes my home base checks. Anyway, that's it, viewers. This episode of Home Base Check is finished. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, I'm going to take my horse through the old town road. I'm going to ride till I can't no more. I'm going to take my horse through the old town road. I'm going to ride till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the back. Horse stock is attached. Head is matted black.